हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू द टुडेज लेक्चर। इन टुडेज लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द मिक्चुरेशन रिफ्लेक्स। ओके, सो इन व्हाट इज मिक्चुरेशन रिफ्लेक्स? बेसिकली मिक्चुरेशन रिफ्लेक्स इज व्हाट, व्हेन एवर वी आवर यूरिनरी ब्लैडर इज फुल विद द यूरिन, दैट एट दैट टाइम आवर ब्रेन गिव अ सेंसेस टू यूरिनेट दैट पर्टिकुलर यूरिन from the urinary bladder. Okay, so that kind of reflexes is known as a urinary micturition reflex. Okay, so now just look at here. First we are going to learn about the structures. So this is the structure of urinary bladder. Okay, and this is the area of urethra. So look at here, in the urinary bladder these blue, dark blue linings are known as a detrusor muscle. Okay, clear everyone? And this red color area, like I draw here, this area, this is known as a urethra, and the upper area, basically these red color muscles are known as internal urethra muscles. Okay, internal urethral muscle. Clear everyone? And these are basically involuntary muscle. Clear everyone? And these blue muscles are known as external urethral muscles. Okay, and these are basically voluntary muscle. Clear everyone? Now just look at this external urethral part is basically a part of urogenital diaphragm. Okay, it is a part of urogenital diaphragm. Now just look at here, these both vessels are basically connected with the ureter. Okay, and from these ureter there is a drop by drop urine is collecting in the urinary bladder. Okay, so this is about the structure of urinary bladder. Now just look at here, what happened on this urinary bladder, we can found so many receptors. Okay, so on this detrusor muscle wall we can found a receptor, beta adrenergic receptors. So this is basically a beta 3 adrenergic receptor, as well as we also found another receptor that is known as muscarinic receptor, this is M3 receptor, as well as on internal urethral muscles we can found the another receptor. That receptor is known as a alpha 1 receptor. This receptor is known as a alpha 1 adrenergic receptor. And on external urethral muscles, we can found the receptor that is known as a nicotinic 1 receptor. Okay, so this is basically a nicotinic 1 receptor. So these are various receptors present on these urinary bladder and urethra. Okay, so if we are talking about the urethra, then in female we have a urethra, and if we are talking about the male, then we have a prostate urethra as well as the other urethra. Clear everyone? Now just looking how we are urinating. So in initial condition, if this urinary bladder is empty, suppose urinary bladder is what? Empty. Clear? In initial condition it is what? Empty. Okay, so in empty condition there is only 10 to 20 ml urine remaining in it. Okay, 10 to 20 ml urine remaining in it. Clear? Just look at the empty condition. Okay, so what happened in the empty condition? This is a balloon, suppose this is a urinary bladder. Okay, so in urinary bladder if it is empty, so look at here, this wall is basically a detrusor muscles. Okay, and this area you can find this is what internal urethral muscles, and this area is basically an external urethral muscle. So suppose this condition is what? The initial condition is, it is an empty condition. So very less amount, 10 to 20 ml urine is filled in this area. Okay, clear everyone? Now just look at here, if 10 to 20 ml urine is filled in this area, then at that time what happened? The detrusor muscles are connected with the our central nervous system. Okay, so these having connection with the afferent neurons. Okay, afferent motor neurons. So just look at here, they are connected with the sacral spinal cord. So look at here, this is sacral spinal cord. Okay, sacral spinal cord. Okay, and this is basically S2, S3 and S4 area. Okay, now this sacral spinal cord, here they are making a synapse with this area, and then what happened? Now they are sending impulses to the thoracolumbar area. Okay, this is the thoracolumbar area. So it is basically T11 to L2. Okay, so now what happened in this area? Now they are making here, these neurons are making synapse with this area, and now from this area they are again making synapse with the inferior mesenteric ganglion. Okay, so they are making synapse with inferior mesenteric ganglion. Clear everyone? Now this inferior mesenteric ganglia is making further connection with these detrusor muscles. Okay, so now with the help of hypogastric nerve, now with the help of hypogastric nerve, they are sending their impulses to the receptor present over here. So the receptor present here are beta-3 adrenergic receptor. So most of the beta receptor which are present here are beta-3. Almost 95% to 97% receptors are beta-3, and the rest of receptors are beta-1 and beta-2. Okay, so now this hypogastric nerve, through this area they are releasing norepinephrine. They are releasing what? Norepinephrine. So now norepinephrine is binding over here. Clear? But what happened actually, whenever it activates sympathetic nervous system, okay, so there is a less amount of urine present here, so there is a less amount of threshold reaching in this direction. So there is basically an inhibition. So now this beta-3 receptor is inhibited. Due to inhibition of beta-3 receptor, what happened? It releases potassium ion from this area and causes relaxation. It causes what? Relaxation. Okay, it relaxes. Okay, so due to relaxation in the detrusor muscles, okay, so now there is a possibility of stretch. Okay, and there is a possibility of collection of more and more urine. So this is the first point. Now another point, what it will do? Now further, they also sending impulses to the internal urethral muscles. The present receptor are alpha-1. So now norepinephrine is also present over here, and it basically is excited. Okay, it activated. So due to activation of alpha-1 receptor, okay, it basically contracted it. Clear everyone? So due to contraction, there is squeezing in this area. There is squeezing in this area. So internal urethral muscles are now contracted. Clear? So our first point is what? The beta 3 receptor present on the urethral detrusor muscles, bladder detrusor muscles. So they are now beta 3, due to beta 3 receptor inhibition, there is a relaxation. There is relaxation. And the alpha 1 receptor present on this area, this internal muscles, okay, the internal urethral muscles, now this is contracted. So this area is closed now, contracted now, and this area is able to relax. Clear everyone? So now due to relaxation and due to contraction, this area is able to collect more and more urine. Okay. Now just look at here what happened further. Here we have these impulses reaches over in the thoracolumbar region, as well as the impulses also propagated on the pons. Okay, in the pons there are two center. There are two center. These center are known as pontine micturition center as well as pontine storage center. So these are, I am drawing with this other pen. Okay, so this is what in blue color, this is pontine storage center, and this is basically pontine micturition center. Clear? So the impulses reaches in this area. Okay, so they are making connection over here. They are making connection over here. Clear? As well as the impulses also reaches into the cerebral cortex. Clear? Now cerebral cortex taking the decision what to do in this condition. So now cerebral cortex take its decision and sending its message to pons. Now what pons will do, it by taking the decision by the cerebral cortex, it activate pontine storage center. It activate basically pontine storage center, and it deactivate pontine micturition center. It deactivate pontine micturition center. Clear everyone? Now just look at here. Pontine storage center is activated. Pontine storage center is activated, and pontine micturition center is inhibited. Due to activation of storage center, what happened now? Just look at here. There is a down regulation of impulses, okay, and they reaches in this area, and they are making synapse with this area. Okay, now they again activated sympathetic activation, okay, and cause further giving the same message to the beta 3 receptor to cause relaxation, as well as they also send the same message on the internal urethral muscles receptor present over here, alpha 1, and due to same activation, the beta 3 receptor cause relaxation and alpha 1 receptor cause contraction. Clear everyone? Now what they further do? Now they also propagate the message in this area, okay, of the sacral spinal cord area. Clear? So in this area, what they will do, they propagate on parasympathetic area. Okay, so now this is the center for parasympathetic nervous system. Parasympathetic nervous system further making synapse with the pudendal nerve. Okay, this is pudendal nerve. Okay, clear everyone? And pudendal nerve is a part of somatic nervous system. Somatic nervous system. Okay, now pudendal nerve further connected with the external urethral muscles, and now they are basically here, they are releasing what? Acetylcholine. They are releasing what? Acetylcholine. Now this acetylcholine is binding on the nicotinic receptor. So now the binding of nicotinic receptor with the acetylcholine cause contraction. It cause what? Contraction. Clear everyone? Okay. So now due to contraction in external urethral muscles, now this area is also contracted now. Okay. But this contraction is voluntary. Okay. Now this is the action of somatic nervous system. What happened further? This is further, the impulse are propagated on this area of lateral gray horn, and they also inhibited the M3 receptor. Okay, so there is inhibition. So they are not releasing acetylcholine. They are not releasing acetylcholine. Generally, by activation of these, they are releasing what? Acetylcholine. And what is the work of acetylcholine? It is binding with the muscarinic receptor, which are M3 type, and muscarinic receptor is causing contraction. Okay, but basically it is inhibited. Due to inhibition of this, what happened? There is a relaxation. There is what? A relaxation. Okay, clear everyone? So this is how the initial area, the bladder area where urine is filled, okay, so the area is relaxed, and the urethral area where the area is contracted by internal urethral muscle as well as external urethral muscles. Okay, now what happened? Now the area is relaxed. So drop by drop, urine is collected in this area. So this area is now filling, regularly filled. Okay, so suppose if the area is filled, okay, now if you are talking about this area is filled now, so here 200 ml up to 200 ml it is filled by the urine. So the 200 ml is the initial mark. 200 ml is the initial mark when our brain said to us that at this time we need to go for urination. Okay, is time par kya hoga? Sabse pehle jab 200 ml urine jab bladder ke andar collect ho jayega, us time par sabse pehle aapko message brain se milega ki ab hame kya karne jana hai, urine ke liye, urination ke liye move karna hai. Okay, we need to go to the bathroom. Okay, so in that condition initially what happened? So now there is a 200 ml urine is collected. Now at this condition, suppose some person are not going for bathroom, okay, in that condition what happened? Now in this condition the bladder still has a capacity to collect more and more urine. Okay, so what happened in this condition? Same. Okay, again there is a stretch. Okay, there is again inhibition of this area and activation of pontine storage center. Okay, and pontine storage center continue to cause inhibition of beta 3 receptor as well as activation of alpha 1 receptor. So it causes relaxation and it causes contraction. So due to relaxation and due to contraction in this area, still urine is coming in this area. Okay, urine is coming in this area. Okay, drop by drop urine is coming in this area. So now what happened? Now urine is again collected. So now due to further more and more collection, what happened? Now we are reaching on 400 to 500 ml collection. Now just look at here, we are comparing with 400 and 500 ml filled urinary bladder to the urinary bladder which is filled only 10 to 20 ml urine. Now just look at here. Okay, now just look at here what we have. These are two urinary bladder. So this urinary bladder is filled only 10 to 20 ml. And now look at here, this urinary bladder, orange color urinary bladder, is filled by 400 to 500 ml urine. Okay, so now just look at here, you can do such kind of experiment here on this orange color urinary bladder. I feel more and more stretch on these wall. Okay, there is too much stretch on this wall, and there is a less amount of stretch in this wall. Clear everyone? Okay, so whenever high amount of urine is filled in the urinary bladder, there is a high amount of stretch on the wall. Clear everyone? I think you are able to understand this point. So now just look at here. Now there is a too much stretch on the wall of urinary bladder. Okay, now stretch is increased. So due to increase in the stretch, what happened? Again the same thing. Here the detrusor muscles are connected through afferent neuron by the sacral area. Okay, sacral spinal cord, S2, S3 and S4 region, which is basically having micturition center. Okay, so now they are making their synapse with this area. Now this they are sending the impulse to the thoracolumbar region, but here they are bypassing this area. Okay, initial what happened in the relaxing area, at the time of relax, they are not bypassing this area, but in this case they are bypassing this area. So what happened? They are bypassing this area, not making any synapse over here, and directly reaching to the pons. Okay, so in pons they are again having connections, again having connection with what? They are connection having PMC. Okay, and as well as they having connection with the PSC. Okay, having connection with the PSC. This is pontine storage center, and this is what? Basically pontine micturition center. Okay, clear everyone? So now they are having connection with both of these. Now again the impulses move on the cerebral cortex. Now cerebral cortex taking its decision and sending their impulses towards this area. Okay, it's sending its decision to this area. I'm drawing with the other color. Okay, just look at here. So it particularly activated PMC, pontine micturition center. Okay, but it inhibited pontine storage center. It inhibited pontine storage center. Okay, so now PMC is activated, pontine micturition center is activated. So pontine micturition center is sending its message or its impulses into the thoracolumbar region, and now again here it making synapse. And what it will do? It further activate. Okay, it further activate beta 3 receptor present over here. Okay, it activate beta 3 receptor present over here. Now beta 3 receptors are due to activation of beta 3 receptor. Now this area is now contracted. This area is now contracted. Okay, clear everyone? Basically activation of beta 3 receptor, and due to activation of beta 3 receptor there is a contraction. Clear? Now what further it also do? It further sending impulses, alpha 1 receptor present on internal urethral muscles. Okay, and then this is basically inhibited. Alpha 1 receptors are inhibited. Basically it releases what? Norepinephrine. Okay, and this is inhibited and beta 3 are activated. So alpha 1 are now inhibited. So due to inhibition, what it will do? It will cause relaxation in this area. It will cause what? relaxation in this area. So now what happened? Beta 3 receptor cause contraction in detrusor muscles. Beta 3 receptor cause contraction in detrusor muscles, and alpha 1 receptor cause relaxation in this urethral internal urethral muscles. Okay, now further what happened? Further, they are going into the this area, sacral area. Okay, and in this sacral area particularly, they are inhibited parasympathetic nervous system. Okay, so by inhibition of parasympathetic nervous system, what happen here? It releases, basically it releases what? Activation of parasympathetic nervous system releases what? Acetylcholine. But here it is deactivated. It is what? Deactivated. So due to deactivation, what happened? It caused further relaxation here, and nicotinic 1 receptors are there, and due to inhibition, nicotinic receptors are not further cause contraction, and they do what? Relaxation. Okay, they do what? Relaxation. Clear? So there is a relaxation. Now internal urethral muscle also relax, and external urethral muscles also relax. Further, they also make connection with the M3 receptor. Okay, what they do? They making connection with the M3 receptor. Okay, here I am drawing what? M3 receptor. Okay, so just look at here. Here they are making connection with the M3 receptor, and M3 receptor are activated by the release of acetylcholine. Here there is a release of acetylcholine, and M3 receptors are now contracting this area. Now they are contracting, contraction of this detrusor muscles. Okay, so what happened in this condition? There are four important points. First, there is a contraction due to beta 3 receptor, basically activation of beta 3 receptor, as well as there is inhibition of alpha 1 receptor. There is inhibition of alpha 1 receptor, so there is a relaxation by the help of alpha 1 receptor, as well as nicotinic receptor cause relaxation due to inhibition. And further, M3 receptor which are contracted. Clear? So now just look at what happened in this condition. Just look at here. This is the what? We have a 400 to 500 ml filled bladder. Okay, now beta 3 receptor cause contraction. Beta 3 cause contraction, as well as suppose beta 3 cause contraction over here, and the M3 receptor also causing contraction over here. Now from this area contraction, this area also contraction. Okay, so what happened? There is a too much pressure over here. So already this internal and external both urethral muscles are already relaxed. So what happened? So at the time of initial relaxation, now the urine come out here, urine come over in this area and also putting pressure on this wall, and then further there is relaxation on the external urethral muscles. So due to this reason, now urine is coming out from the human body. Clear everyone? So this is all about micturition reflex. Okay, I'm just summarizing all the point, what happened at the time of empty bladder and what happened at the time of full bladder. Okay, full bladder. Clear? So just a quick recap of all of the lecture. Initially what happened? There is only 10 to 20 ml urine is there, so there is a less amount of stretch. Due to less amount of stress, there is a less activation of sympathetic area, so sacral spinal cord sending their impulses in this thoracolumbar region, and then they making synapse with inferior mesenteric ganglion. Now inferior mesenteric ganglion are connected with the hypogastric nerves, and now these are releasing norepinephrine, but due to inhibition, beta 3 receptor causing relaxation, as well as alpha 1 receptor is activated and it causes contraction in internal urethral muscles. Okay, and then further what happen? There is a further sending impulses to the pons, and in pons we have a PMC and PSC, as well as the impulses also reaches in the cerebral cortex, and cerebral cortex sending message to the PSC. Okay, pontine storage center. Now pontine storage center further active inhibited sympathetic system, okay, and further cause relaxation by beta 3 as well as contraction on internal urethral muscle by contracting it. Okay, further what happened? There is activation of parasympathetic nervous system. Okay, and due to activation of parasympathetic nervous system, what happened? There is a further release of acetylcholine, and acetylcholine cause contraction in this area. Okay, external urethral muscle by nicotinic 1 receptor. Okay, so this area is contracted, and this here on the detrusor muscle we have a M3 receptor, and these M3 receptor are not getting as much as acetylcholine they require. Okay, so due to inhibition of this area is also relaxed. Okay, now what happened in further condition? Now the bladder is able to collect more and more urine. So there is the urine is collected in this area. So initial 200 ml urine is collected. Now person is feeling what? He has to go for urination. Okay, so now still if it is not go, then further urine is more and more collected, and after 400 to 500 ml, then there is a micturition reflex is again started. Okay, so what happened again? Sacral spinal cord is connected with the motor neurons, and these motor neurons further what they will do? Making connection with the pons by bypassing this thoracolumbar region. Okay, and then sending message impulses to the cerebral cortex, and cerebral cortex activated pontine micturition center, and pontine micturition center what it caused? It activated beta 3 receptor. Okay, and then it beta 3 receptor now contracted. Okay, and then further it inhibited alpha 1 receptor, and due to inhibition of alpha 1 receptor there is a relaxation. Okay, and then further what happened? Parasympathetic nervous system is inhibited. Due to inhibition of parasympathetic nervous system, there is a less amount of acetylcholine is secreted, and due to less amount of acetylcholine secreted, and nicotinic receptor is relaxed. So there is a relaxation on internal urethral muscle as well as external urethral muscle, both there are relaxation, and beta 3 contracted the detrusor muscle, and M3 receptor also contracted the detrusor muscle. So by this way urine is passing from the urinary bladder. Clear everyone? Hello everyone, now it's time for question round. Question number 1. Micturition reflex is controlled by A. Sympathetic nervous system, B. Parasympathetic nervous system, C. both of these, and D. none of these. Question number 2. The internal urethral muscles have A. involuntary control, B. voluntary control, C. both of these, and D. none of these. Question number 3. The external urethral muscle have A. involuntary control, B. voluntary control, C. both of these, and D. none of these. Question number 4. When urinary bladder is full up to 400 to 500 ml, which of the following statement is correct? A. Detrusor muscle contract, B. internal and external urethral muscle contract, C. both of these, and D. none of these. Question number 5. When urinary bladder is full up to 10 to 20 ml, which of the following statement is correct? A. Detrusor muscle relax, B. internal and external urethral muscle contract, C. both of these, and D. none of these. So I have already given answer of all of these question in my lecture. So go through with my lecture and answer in comment box. So hopefully whatever the material I gave regarding the renal maturation reflex, you guys may enjoy a lot. And if you like the lecture, then hit the like button as well as share the lecture and subscribe the channel.